गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, गुड मॉर्निंग टू वन एंड ऑल। दिस इज माय फिफ्थ लेक्चर ऑन डिजाइन ऑफ मिशन मेंबर्स टू सब्जेक्ट एंड यूनिट वन डिजाइन ऑफ बेयरिंग्स। एंड टुडेज टॉपिक इज डिजाइन प्रोसीजर ऑफ ए जर्नल बेयरिंग। ओके, डिजाइन ऑफ ए जर्नल बेयरिंग। इन दिस सेशन आई विल एक्सप्लेन हाउ टू डिजाइन ए जर्नल बेयरिंग by using simple techniques, and also in this session I will explain what is the importance of viscosity, and also I am going to explain about absolute viscosity and kinematic viscosity and their units also I will explain in this session. This is the example for viscosity. Here, this figure consists of a top moving plate. It is moving with a velocity v. Okay, this top cover plate moving with a velocity v, and bottom stationary plate at a depth of h. Okay. Here I treated this bottom stationary plate as a bearing surface, and this top moving plate treated as a shaft surface. The depth of this h indicates depth of lubricant between the shaft and bearing. Okay. What is the importance of viscosity? What is viscosity and what is the importance of viscosity in bearings? First of all, you have to know what is the property of a viscosity. Viscosity is an important fluid property when analyzing liquid behavior, liquid or lubricant behavior. Okay, lubricant also a liquid, so that's why viscosity is useful to analyze the behavior of a liquid or lubricant and fluid motion near solid boundaries. Okay, viscosity is useful to analyze the behavior of a lubricant and lubricant motion near solid boundaries. Okay, the viscosity of a fluid is a measure of its resistance to gradual deformation by shear stress or tensile stress. Okay, the shear resistance in a fluid is caused by intermolecular friction exerted when layers of fluid attempt to slide by one another. Okay, the viscosity of a fluid is highly temperature dependent. Okay, so the behavior of a lubricant depends upon temperature. So the behavior of a lubricant also depends upon viscosity. That viscosity depends upon temperature. So viscosity is a measure of fluid's resistance to flow. Okay, so here I am showing some examples. Molasses. All of you know about molasses. That molasses is highly viscous. Okay, molasses having highly viscous in nature. Okay. Similarly, water. Normal water already all of you know about water, but that water is a medium viscous. Okay. Now gas, any type of gas is a low viscous. Okay. So gases are not suitable for lubricants. Okay, because gases are having low viscosity, and water also is not suitable for lubricants. Okay. Now here there are two related measures of fluid viscosity. That one, first one is dynamic viscosity, or absolute viscosity, and second one is kinematic viscosity. Okay. Yeah. In next slide, I will explain about these two types, that is dynamic viscosity and kinematic viscosity. And also, I will explain how to indicate these two values. Kinematic viscosity. Okay. Kinematic viscosity is the ratio of absolute or dynamic viscosity to density. Okay, this is the formula for kinematic viscosity. Kinematic viscosity is the ratio of absolute viscosity to the density of a lubricant. Okay, a quantity in which no force is involved. Okay, kinematic viscosity is the ratio of dynamic viscosity to density, and the formula is like this. So here, kinematic viscosity K equal to absolute or dynamic viscosity of a lubricant divided by density of a lubricant material. Rho, this is the symbol for density. Okay, rho is the symbol for density. Here, rho is the density of a lubricant material. Okay, so here where rho equal to density of the lubricating oil. In the SI system, the theoretical unit of kinematic viscosity is, in SI units, the value of the SI unit for kinematic viscosity is meter square per second. Okay, meter square per second is the unit for kinematic viscosity. And also other unit is there, that is a stroke. Okay, it is denoted by ST. Here one stroke or one ST equal to 10 power minus 4 meter square per second. Okay, 10 power minus 4 meter square per second, or one stroke equal to 1 centimeter square per second. Okay, these are the units for kinematic viscosity. Okay, kinematic viscosity is the ratio of absolute viscosity to the density of the lubricating oil. Okay, this is the formula for viscosity. Okay, and these are the units for kinematic viscosity. Okay. Now, yeah, this is the very important for our subject point of view, and this one also used in our problems. So here Z is the symbol for absolute viscosity or dynamic viscosity. Absolute viscosity or dynamic viscosity. Dynamic viscosity, also known as absolute viscosity, is the measurement of the fluid's internal resistance, to flow. Okay, dynamic viscosity also is the measurement of the fluid's internal resistance to flow. And the formula for absolute viscosity or dynamic viscosity is equal to rho into kinematic viscosity, where rho is the density of the lubricating oil. Okay, so absolute viscosity, also known as dynamic viscosity, and the formula is absolute viscosity or dynamic viscosity is equal to density of the lubricating oil is multiply with the kinematic viscosity. Okay, this is the formula for Z. Okay, now for liquids, viscosity decreases with high temperature. Okay, for liquids, viscosity decreases with higher temperature. So therefore, the property of the lubricant or the behavior of the lubricant depends upon the temperature. Okay, so viscosity also depends upon temperature. That's why temperature is more important for identifying the behavior of a lubricant. Okay, so for liquids, viscosity decreases with the higher temperature. Okay, at higher temperatures the viscosity is low for liquids. Okay, now these are the some examples for viscosity, for absolute viscosity. This column indicates type of liquid, and this column indicates value of absolute viscosity. Here the units for absolute viscosity is in Newton second per meter square or Pascal second. Okay, absolute viscosity for air it having value 1.983 into 10 power minus 5. 1.983 into 10 power minus 5 is the value for absolute viscosity of air. Okay, and 10 power minus 3 is the value of absolute viscosity of water. Okay, here 10 power minus 1 is the value of viscosity of olive oil. Okay, 10 power 0 is for glycerol. Okay, and 10 power 1 for liquid honey. Okay, 10 power 1 for honey, and 10 power 2 for golden syrup, and 10 power 40 for glass material. Okay, these are the values for absolute viscosity of some standard liquids. Okay, here you can observe here the value of absolute viscosity for air, water is very less. Okay, because these two are having less density. Okay, now what are the units for absolute viscosity? Here capital Z is a symbol for absolute viscosity or dynamic viscosity, and the SI units, here these are the SI units for absolute viscosity. Here in SI units, force is indicated by Newton. Okay, and time indicated in second, and distance indicated in meters. Therefore, for SI units, for in SI system, the units for absolute viscosity is Newton second per meter square. Okay, Newton second per meter square is the SI unit for absolute viscosity, and where where Newton per meter square equal to 1 Pascal. Therefore, here Newton per meter square equal to 1 Pascal into second. So, Pascal and second also unit for absolute viscosity. These two are SI units. Okay. And MKS in MKS system, mass in kgf, mass or force in kgf, kg force, and time in seconds, and distance in kilometers or meters. Okay, so therefore this is the unit for absolute viscosity in MKS units. Okay, in MKS units, the units for absolute viscosity is kg force second per meter square, where just you have to replace Newton by kgf. Okay, time is same and distance is same. Okay, therefore kg force second per meter square is the unit for absolute viscosity. All of you know about 1 kg force equal to 9.81 newtons. okay, 1 kg force equal to 9.81 newtons. Therefore, if you want to convert this unit into SI units, then just you have to multiply with 9.81 for this unit. Okay, 1 kg force equal to 9.81 newton second per meter square. Therefore, the value of here 1 kg second per meter square equal to 9.81 pascal second. Okay, whereas in CGS system, okay, whereas CGS system, the units are in dyne. Here force in dynes, force in dyne, time in seconds, and distance in centimeters. Therefore the units for absolute viscosity in CGS units is dyne second per centimeter square. Okay, here dyne is the representation of force in CGS units. Centimeter is the representation of distance in CGS units. Therefore, dyne second per centimeter square is the unit for CGS system. And here 1 dyne second per centimeter square, also called poise, 1 poise. Okay, therefore 1 poise, 1 poise equal to dyne second per centimeter square, whereas 10 poise equal to Newton second per meter square. 10 poise equal to Newton second per meter square, or 10 poise equal to 1 Pascal second. Okay, 10 poise value equal to 1 Newton second per meter square. Okay, now similarly, therefore 1 poise equal to 1 by 10 Newton second per meter square. Okay, and also same for 1 poise equal to 100 centipoise. Okay, 1 poise equal to 100 centipoise. Same as 1000 centipoise. 1000 centipoise equal to 1 Newton second per meter square. Because here 1 Newton second per meter square equal to 10 poise. Again, 1 poise equal to 100 centipoise. So 10 into 100, that is 1000. 1000 centipoise equal to 1 Newton second per meter square. Okay, and also 1000 centipoise equal to 10 poise. Okay, these are the units for absolute viscosity. Okay, these units are very important for calculating the general problems. Okay, now It is very important. That is a bearing characteristic number and bearing modulus for general bearings. Here, the bearing characteristic number is indicated by a letter Zn by P. Okay. Bearing characteristic number is Zn by P. Z is the absolute viscosity. Okay. Here Z, capital Z is the already we have discussed about Z value in before slide. Okay. Z is the absolute viscosity of the lubricant in kg per meter second. Okay. That is a kg force. That is in kg force. Now N, capital N, N is the speed of a shaft. Capital N is the speed of a shaft. Speed of a shaft or speed of a journal in RPM. RPM means revolution per minute. Okay. Where P is the pressure, bearing pressure. Pressure acting on bearing surface. Okay. That is a bearing pressure on the projected bearing area. Okay, here bearing pressure P equal to load on the shaft divided by projected area. Here small l is the length of the bearing and small d is the diameter of the shaft. Okay, diameter of the shaft small d and l is the length of the bearing and small C or capital C is the diametral clearance. Okay, C is the diametral clearance. Diametral, already in previous class we have discussed about diametral clearance. What is the diametral clearance? The diametral clearance is the difference between the diameter of the bearing and diameter of the shaft. Okay. The difference between the diameter of the bearing and the diameter of the shaft is called diameter clearance. Okay, clearance means the gap between the bearing and shaft surface. Okay, therefore it is indicated by symbol C for diameter clearance. And the formula for the diameter clearance is capital diameter of the bearing capital D minus diameter of the shaft small d. Okay, Zn by P, the factor Zn by P is termed as a bearing characteristic number. Okay, it is termed as a bearing characteristic number. It is a dimensionless number. Okay, that means there is no unit for Zn by P. Okay, no units for Zn by P. Okay, the factor Zn by P helps. The factor Zn by P helps to predict the performance of a bearing. Okay. The factor Zn by P helps to predict the performance of a bearing. Okay, Zn by P helps to predict the performance of a bearing and the variation of coefficient of friction with operating values of bearing characteristic number Zn by P. Okay, as obtained by McKee brothers. This is S.A. McKee and T.R. McKee. In an actual test of friction, we shown it there. Okay, the coefficient of friction in design of bearings is of great importance because it affords a means for determining the loss of power due to bearing friction. Okay, it has been shown by experiments that the coefficient of friction for a full lubricated journal bearing is a function of three variables. Okay. That is a function of Zn by P and D by C and L by D. Here Zn by P is called a bearing characteristic number and D by C is called a diameter clearance ratio, and where L by D ratio is the length and diameter ratio. Okay, this first one is a bearing characteristic number. Okay, Z is the absolute viscosity, N is the speed of a journal, and P is the bearing pressure. Okay, and where d by c is called diameter and clearance ratio. D is the diameter of a journal, diameter of a shaft, and c is the diameter clearance, that is a capital D minus small d. Okay, and L by D is the length and diameter ratio. Here L is the length of the bearing, and D is the diameter of the shaft. Okay, for designing of journal bearings, these three parameters are very important for calculating the amount of heat dissipated and amount of heat generated. Okay, these three values are very important in journal bearings design. Okay, now coming to the design procedure of a journal bearing, first of all you have to know about a Sommerfeld number. It is not used frequently. Sommerfeld number is also a dimensionless parameter. That means, so this one also having no units for Sommerfeld number, and it is used extensively in the design of journal bearings. Mathematically, for design purposes, its value is taken as Zn by P into D by C whole power 2. This is the formula for Sommerfeld number. Okay, this is the formula for Sommerfeld number, and the value of Sommerfeld number is 14.3 into 10 power 6. Okay, this is the value of a Sommerfeld number. Okay, here the Z value, the units for Z is in kg per meter second, and speed in RPM, and bearing pressure in Newton per mm square. Yeah, okay. Now it is the very important one, that is friction, coefficient of friction for journal bearings, that is mu. Coefficient of friction for journal bearings, it is denoted by symbol mu. Mu is the symbol for coefficient of friction. Okay, in order to determine the coefficient of friction for well lubricated full journal bearings, the following empirical relation established by Mackey based on the experimental data may be used. Okay, this is the formula for coefficient of friction for journal bearings. Okay, coefficient of friction is denoted by symbol mu. That value mu equal to 33 by 10 power 8, and Zn into Zn by P into D by C plus small k. Okay, this is the formula for coefficient of friction. Okay, where here Z is in kg per meter second, where the units for absolute viscosity, Z is kg per meter second, and bearing pressure is in Newton per mm square. Okay, here the bearing pressure is in Newton per mm square, and Z is in kg per meter second. Okay, this is very important for our problems. Okay, here small k is the correction factor for end leakage. Okay, it depends upon the ratio of L by D. The value of correction factor depends upon ratio of L by D. That is, for general purpose, for L by D ratios 0.75 to 2.8, the K value is equal to 0.002. Okay, the value of K is 0.002 for L by D ratios of 0.75 to 2.8. Okay, this is the formula for coefficient of friction. Okay, heat generated in zonal bearing. Next one is this one also very important to identify the amount of heat generated in bearing surfaces. Okay, the heat generated in a bearing is due to the fluid friction and the friction of the parts having relative motion. Okay, mathematically heat generated in a bearing is indicated by Q suffix G means Q is the symbol for heat and G is the symbol for generation. So heat generated equal to QG equal to mu into W into V. Okay, here where mu is the coefficient of friction. Okay, mu value is considered from previous formula, and where W is the load. W is the load on the bearing. W is the load on the bearing. That load W equal to pressure, bearing pressure into and length of the bearing into diameter of the shaft. This is the formula for load on bearing. Okay, bearing pressure into length of the bearing into diameter of the shaft. This is the formula for load on the bearing. Okay, whereas V is the velocity, rubbing velocity or velocity of the shaft. Here rubbing velocity of the shaft V equal to pi d n by 60. Here pi d represents one complete revolution. Okay, for one complete revolution you have to consider one circumference, that is one turn, that is equal to pi d. Okay, pi d multiply with the number of revolutions per minute, that is n is the symbol for rpm, revolution per minute. Okay, so pi dn by 60 is the formula for velocity of a shaft. Okay, pi dn by 60 is the formula for velocity of a shaft. So here mu having no units. Okay, coefficient of friction also dimensionless number. Okay, so there is no units for mu, and load in newtons and velocity in meter per second. So therefore the units for heat generation, the units for heat generation is newton meter per second. Okay, there is no units for mu. Okay, newtons for load and meter per second for velocity. So therefore the units for heat generation is newton meter per second. Already we know that one newton meter equal joule. So therefore joule per second also units for QG, and also it is indicated by units watts. 1 watt equal to joule per second. Okay, 1 joule per second or newton meter per second or watt. Okay, these are the units for heat generation. Okay, so these are the units for heat. Okay friends, this formula is very important to determine the value of heat generation. Okay, now here diameter of the journal, small d is the diameter of the journal, and the capital N is the speed of the journal, and P is the pressure on the bearing. Okay, next one is this one also very important for bearing. Heat dissipation in a journal bearing. Okay, heat dissipation means amount of heat cooled. Okay, amount of heat removed from bearing surfaces is called heat dissipation. Okay, after the thermal equilibrium has been reached, heat will be dissipated at the outer surface of the bearing. Okay, outer surface of the bearing at the same rate at which it is generated in the oil film. The amount of heat dissipated will depend upon the temperature difference. Bearing surface and surrounding temperature and size of the bearing and mass of the lubricating oil. And amount of air flowing around the bearing. These are the factors affecting the heat dissipation. Okay. However, for the convenience in bearing design, the actual heat dissipating area may be expressed in terms of the projected area of the journal. Okay. Heat dissipated by the bearing QD. QD equal to C into A TB minus TA. Okay, this is the formula for heat dissipation. And another formula is there, that is QD equal to CA into T naught minus TA by 2. The units for heat dissipation also same for heat generation, that is watts, joule per second or watt or newton meter per second. Okay. And once again, I repeat the formula for heat dissipation. QD equal to CA into TB minus TA, where capital A, CA, TB minus TA, here capital A is the projected area of the bearing. Okay, projected area of the bearing is nothing but length of the bearing into diameter of the shaft. Length of the bearing and multiply with the diameter of the shaft is a formula for area. Okay, where capital C, TB is the temperature of the bearing surface temperature. TB is the bearing surface temperature, whereas TA is the surrounding air temperature. TA and T naught is the operating temperature of the oil film. Okay, T naught is the operating temperature of a lubricant. Okay, where capital C is the heat dissipation coefficient. The units for heat dissipation coefficient is W by meter square by degree Celsius. Okay, the units for heat dissipation coefficient is watts per meter square per degree Celsius. Okay, this is the unit for heat dissipation coefficient. And for general purpose, for unventilated bearings, okay, there is no air cooling, still there is no airflow. So then you can consider the value of heat dissipation coefficient capital C equal to 140 to 420 watts per meter square per degree Celsius for unventilated bearings. Okay. Similarly, for well ventilated bearings, you may consider C equal to 490 to 1400 watts per meter square per degree Celsius. These are the general values for heat dissipation coefficient. Okay. It has been shown by experiments that the temperature of the bearing TB is approximately midway between the temperature of the oil film T naught and the temperature of the outside area TA. Okay, here TB minus TA equal to half of the T naught minus TA. Okay, these are the formulas for heat dissipation. Now, another last formula for design of journal bearings. This is the last formula for design of journal bearing. Mass of lubricant oil required for artificial cooling, M. M is the mass of the lubricating oil required for artificial cooling. We know that the taken away by the oil, we know that the heat taken away by the oil equal to QT. QT equal to MST. Here, QT is the amount of heat taken away by the oil. Okay. Whereas m is the mass of the lubricating oil required for artificial cooling in kg, in kgs per second, kgs per second. Okay, now we need a formula for mass of the lubricant oil required. So therefore m equal to qt by st. This is the formula for mass of the lubricant required for artificial cooling. Okay, here qt, what is the formula for qt? Amount of heat taken away by the oil. That qt equal to the difference between the amount of heat generated minus amount of heat dissipated. Okay, the difference between the amount of heat generated and the amount of heat dissipation is the formula for qt. Qt is the amount of heat taken away by the oil. Okay, amount of heat taken away by the oil is equal to qg minus qd. Okay, now here S, capital S, is the specific heat of the oil. Specific heat of the oil, its value may be taken as 1840 to 2100 joule per kg per degree Celsius. Okay, and the difference between outlet and inlet temperature of the oil in degree Celsius, where small t is the difference between the outlet and inlet temperature of the oil. Okay, these are the formulas for lubricating oil required for artificial cooling. Okay, now I am explaining about design procedure of a journal bearing. The following procedure may be adopted in designing journal bearing when the bearing load, the diameter and the speed of the shaft are known. Okay, now the first step for design of journal bearing is first of all you have to determine the bearing length. Length of a bearing by choosing a ratio of L by D. From data handbook. Okay. Now the second step for design of bearing is bearing pressure. In second step, you have to find the value of bearing pressure. Sufficient, first of all, you have to determine sufficient bearing pressure. Here the bearing pressure, the formula for bearing pressure, P equal to load by W by L into D. Here P is the bearing pressure and W is the load on the bearing divided by L into D. L means length of the bearing and D is the diameter of the shaft. Okay, D is the diameter of the shaft. This is the formula for bearing pressure. This value also you have to consider from data handbook. Okay. Now the third step for design of journal bearing is assume a suitable lubricant type. Okay. You have to consider a suitable lubricant type from data handbook graphs and its operating temperature T naught. Okay, by using data handbook, you have to consider a suitable lubricant type by using a graph between the absolute viscosity and operating temperature T naught. The examples for lubricant oils are SAE 10, SAE 10, SAE 20, SAE 30, SAE 40, 50, 60. These are the names for lubricants. Okay, SAE 10, SAE 20, SAE 30, SAE 40, 50, 60, 70. These are the names for lubricants. Okay, now in fourth step, you have to find the value of a bearing characteristic number. Okay, in the fourth step, you have to find the value of bearing characteristic number by substituting the given data Z value, N value, and P value. You have to substitute absolute viscosity Z and speed of a shaft and pressure, bearing pressure. Then you will get the answer for bearing characteristic number Z by P. And you have to compare with this value with the data handbook value. Okay. Then to determine the possibility of maintaining fluid film operation. Okay. Now, fifth step. Now in fifth step, you have to consider a clearance ratio. Clearance ratio, that means C by D from data handbook. Okay, C is the diametral clearance ratio. Diametral clearance. C is the symbol for diameter clearance. That is diameter clearance. C equal to difference between diameter of a bearing minus diameter of a shaft. Capital D minus small d. Formula for C. Okay. From data handbook, you have to consider the suitable value for C by D. But in general applications, the value of C by D is considered as C by D equal 0.003. Okay. And in sixth step, you have to find the value of coefficient of friction. Okay. In sixth step, you have to find the value of coefficient of friction between the bearing surface and shaft surface. Okay. Already in previous we have discussed about this coefficient of friction. Okay, coefficient of friction is indicated by symbol mu. Okay, the formula for coefficient of friction is 33 by 10 power 8 Z by P into D by C plus small k. Okay, this is the formula for coefficient of friction. There is no units for coefficient of friction. Okay, no units for coefficient of friction. Here the value of Z in kg per meter second, and the value of N in RPM, revolution per minute, and the value of P in Newton per mm square. Okay, and the value of K is 0.002 for L by D ratios of 0.75 to 2.8, where small k is a end leakage factor. Okay, this small k value depends upon the ratio of L by D. Okay, and determine in seventh step you have to determine the amount of heat generated by lubricant. The formula for amount of heat generated is equal to Qg equal to mu into W into V. Okay, this is the formula for heat generation. The units for heat generation is joule per second or watts or Newton meter per second. These are the units for heat generation. Okay, where mu is the coefficient of friction and W is the load on the shaft and V is the rubbing velocity of the shaft. Okay, and here the mu has no units, load in newtons and velocity in meter per second. Therefore the units for heat generation equal Newton meter per second. Okay, now coming to the eighth step, you have to find the value of heat dissipation by using empirical relation formula. That is Qd equal to Ca into Tb minus Ta, or Qd equal to Ca into T naught minus Ta by 2. The units are same. The units are same for heat dissipation as well as heat generation. Both are same units. here C, capital C is the heat dissipation coefficient. Capital C is the heat dissipation coefficient. Capital A is the projected area. Projected area means length of the bearing into diameter of the shaft. Okay. TB is the bearing surface temperature. TB is the bearing surface temperature. TA is the atmospheric temperature. Okay. T naught is the operating temperature, and now coming to the last step in design of journal bearing. In the last step, you have to find the value of amount of mass of lubricant required for artificial cooling. You have to find that value, the formula for amount of mass of lubricant oil required for artificial cooling is equal to qt by s into t. Okay, this is the formula for mass of lubricating oil required, where qt is the amount of heat taken away by the lubricant. Okay, here qt is the amount of heat taken away by the lubricant. That is qt equal to amount of heat generated minus amount of heat dissipated. Here amount of heat generated equal to mu wv, and amount of heat dissipated equal to Ca T naught minus Ta by 2. Okay, this is now where S is the specific heat of the lubricant. Okay, and T is the rise of temperature. Okay, T is the rise of temperature. Now these 9 steps are used to design the journal bearings. Okay. Here the specific heat of the oil may be taken as 1840 to 2100 joule per kg per degree Celsius. Okay. If any doubts, please ask me. Please ask any doubt.